स्टूडेंट लेट्स सी दी स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस। सो स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस मीन्स दैट इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द स्पर्मेटोजोआ इनटू दैट द टेस्टिस। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस यू मस्ट नो अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द स्पर्मेटोजोआ। सो द स्पर्मेटोजोआ इट इज द मेल सेक्स सेल एंड इट इज हाईली स्पेशलाइज फ्री स्विमिंग एक्टिविटी मोटाइल सेल। द स्पर्मेटोजोआ इट मेजर्स अबाउट द 16 micrometer in length. Then it consists of the head, neck, middle piece, then the principal piece or the tail, and the axial filament passes through the middle piece and extends into that the tail. So let's see first that is the structure of the spermatozoa. So here in this diagram you can see that is the structure of the sperm. So it consists of the head, then second one, that is this is the neck, this one, then the third one, that is the middle piece, and the principal piece, or that is called the tail. So this one, so that is the structure of the spermatozoa. So let's see that is the detail of the structure of the sperm cell. Then let's see the head of the spermatozoa. So the head of the human spermatozoa, it is piriform in shape and it is measures about 4 micron in the length. Then it is derived from the nucleus, which consists of the 23 highly condensed chromosome. The head, it is covered by the cap like structure, it is called the acrosome or the acrosomic cap. The acrosome, it consists of the enzyme that is help for the penetration of the spermatozoa into that the ovum during the fertilization. Then that is the neck. So neck, it is narrow and it consists of the funnel shaped base cell body and the spherical centriole. So for this we should have to see the another diagram. So here in this diagram you can see that is this is the neck, this is head, this is neck, and it consists of that is the funnel shape, this one, that is called the basal body, and centrally present this structure, it is called the centriole. So the basal body, it is also called the connecting piece because it is help to establish an immediate connection between that the head and the remaining part of the spermatozoa. Then the axial filament, so this one, the vertical linings are seen, that is called the axial filament. So the axial filament, it begins just behind the centriole. So from this here you can see, and it passes through the middle piece and most of the tail of the spermatozoa. The axial filament, it passes through the ring like structure, it is called the annulus. So here you can see that is called the annulus. The part of the axial filament which lies in the middle piece, which is surrounded by a spiral sheath. So this one, that is called the mitochondria. So here blue color spiral sheath is seen, that is called the mitochondria. Then the axial filament, it is actually composed of the several fibrils which are arranged into the different layers. There is a pair of central fibrils, so this one, which is surrounded by the 9 pairs, that is the doublets, arranged in the circle around the central pair. The whole system of the fibril, it is kept in position by the series of the covering. Then immediately the outside that the fibril, there is the fibrous sheath, and in region of the middle piece, the fibrous sheath, it is surrounded by spirally arranged that the mitochondria. Finally, the remaining part and the entire spermatozoa, it is enclosed by the plasma membrane. So that is the outer covering, it is called the plasma membrane. So here in this diagram you can see that is that the outer covering, that is the plasma membrane, and that is the axial filament, which starts from that the middle piece, that is throughoutly entire into that the proximal piece or the tail of the spermatozoa. So here in this diagram you can see that is the transverse section across the principal piece of the spermatozoa. So here centrally, that is a pair of axial filament is present, which is covered by, that is the 9 pairs, which is called the doublets. Then on outer side here, that is the coarse petal are present, that is called the mitochondria, this one. And outermost side here, that should be forming, that is the fibrous sheath. So this one. Hello student. So after completion of the structure of the spermatozoa, let's see the spermatogenesis. So as you know, spermatogenesis means the formation of the gametes or the spermatozoa in the reproductive period of the male. So in male, the reproductive period, it starts from the puberty, means at from the age of 12 to 16 year till the old age. So it is formed, or the sperm or the spermatozoa, it is formed into that the seminiferous tubule of the testicles. And whenever we see the section of the testicles or the seminiferous tubule, we observe the different stages of the spermatogenetic cell. And the other cells are also formed, that is called the cells of Sertoli. So the cells of Sertoli, that is only help for the supporting function. And the other cells, that is the different stages of the formation of the spermatozoites or the spermatozoa, that should be seen into that the section. So let's see how that the process of the spermatogenesis, that should be occurs into that the testes. So this is the spermatogenesis. So the spermatogenesis, it takes place, as you know, in the seminiferous tubule of the testes from the primordial germ cell called the spermatogonia. So here you can see that is called the spermatogonia. And this spermatogonia goes undergo the series of division to form the male germ cell, that is called the spermatozoa. So last one, this one, that is called the spermatozoa. So let's start the process of the spermatogenesis. So first, that is the spermatogonia, which is A type, or the germ cell, which consists of the 44 chromosome plus X and Y, means that is total 46 chromosomes are present, which divides mitotically to give rise more spermatogonia type A. So this one, type A. And it also gives to spermatogonia type B, which consists of same 44 chromosomes plus X and Y, 6 chromosome. Then the spermatogonia B, that consists of the 44 autosomes and X and Y, 6 chromosomes, means total 46 chromosomes or the 23 pairs. It undergo the mitotic division to form the primary spermatocyte. So here, as it is the mitotic division, so it consists of the same 44 autosome plus X and Y, a pair of 6 chromosome, means that consists of same 46 chromosomes are present. Then the primary spermatocyte then now divide so that each forms a two secondary spermatocytes, and this is the first meiotic division. So here you can see, which consists of, that is 22 autosome plus X and 22 autosome plus Y chromosome, means that consists of the 23 chromosome and that consists of the 23 chromosome, means half chromosomes are present from the primary spermatocyte as the meiotic division it should be start. Then the secondary spermatocyte has you know, that is the 23 and the 23 chromosome, and it divide to spermatid. So here you can see, that is the secondary spermatocyte, it divides, that is the 2, and this divide into 2, and that is the second meiotic division. But as it is the second meiotic division, but the chromosome, that is not changes, so that is the 22 plus X chromosome, that should be divided, meiotic division same like the 22X plus into that the second 22X. Then other secondary spermatocyte, that consists of 22 plus Y chromosome, so it should be formed the 22 Y chromosome plus 22 Y chromosome. Then that is this four form, it is called the spermatid. Then the spermatid, it should be goes gradually changes its shape and becomes that the spermatozoa, this one. So the process of transformation of circular spermatid into that the spermatozoa. So that is called the spermatogenesis. So this one. So let's see, that is the changes should be occur into that the spermatogenesis. So after the spermatogenesis, let's see, that is the spermiogenesis. So the spermiogenesis, it involves the process of conversion of the spermatid into that the spermatozoa. And the difference between that is the spermiogenesis and the spermatogenesis. That is the spermatogenesis, it is the complete process of the formation of the spermatozoa from the spermatogonium. And the spermiogenesis, that is starting from, that is the conversion of the spermatid into that the spermatozoa. So let's see, that is the process of the conversion of the spermatid into that the spermatozoa. So the spermatid, it is the rounded cell which consists of the nucleus, Golgi complex, Golgi apparatus, mitochondria and the centriole. And all the structure, they should be changes and it should be formed, that is fully formed, that is the spermatozoa. So let's see first, that is the nucleus. So the nucleus, it consists of the nuclear material, that is called the chromatin. And it is highly convoluted. The nucleus, it moves on the one side of the cell gradually and gradually. So here you can see this one, and it forming that the head of the spermatozoa. Then the Golgi complex, so this one. So Golgi complex, it should be form the acrosomal cap of the spermatozoa, or that is called the acrosome. So this one. Then the centriole. This one. So centriole divides into that the two part. That is the one centriole moves towards the posterior end of the nucleus and forming that the axial filament. So this one. And the other centriole, it moves away from the first to form that the annulus. So this one. Then next to it, that is the mitochondria. So here, that is the mitochondria. Then that is the mitochondria. So this one, that is the mitochondria, it should be accumulate around that the axial filament. So centrally, that is the axial filament is present, and it should be around that the mitochondria are present from the proximal centriole to that the annulus. Then the part of it form the middle piece of the spermatozoa. And the most of the cytoplasm shed out, and the cell membrane remains which covers, that is the entire spermatozoa. So that is the cell membrane. Then the axial filament. So the axial filament, it is concerned with the movement of the spermatozoa, while that the mitochondria in the middle piece supply energy for the movement. Then the head contains the nucleus. So here, which is during the fertilization forms the male pronucleus. Then let's see the maturation and the capacitation of the spermatozoa. So when the spermatozoa, it is formed into that the seminiferous tubule, those spermatozoa, they are immature in nature and they are non-motile and incapable of the fertilizing a ovum. A current fluid into that the seminiferous tubule, it carries spermatozoa from the testes to that the epididymis, this one. And here into that the epididymis, it is stored for the maturation. So as the spermatozoa, it passes through that the epididymis, a changes takes place in the glycoprotein of the plasma membrane covering that the sperm head. The spermatozoa acquired some mobility after the maturation, but it become fully motile only after the ejaculation, when they are get mixed up with the secretion of the prostate gland and the seminal vesicle. So here in this diagram you can see when that the spermatozoa, they should be ejaculated and enters into that the seminal vesicle, and here that is the prostate gland is present. So that is the fluid from the prostate gland and the fluid from the seminal vesicle, it should be mixed with that the spermatozoa, and it occurs the great motile ability. That is the spermatozoa, acquire the ability to fertilize an ovum only after when it they have been into that the female genital tract. This is the final step there of their maturation, and it is called the capacitation. In the process of the capacitation, the glycoprotein and the seminal protein laying over the surface of the spermatozoa are altered. The spermatozoa usually undergo the capacitation in the uterus and the uterine tube. Under the influence of the substances secreted by the female genital tract.